Good afternoon. Sorry, everybody, for the late start here. Had a combination of being stuck behind gravel trucks, technical difficulties, and slow internet getting us here. Starting a little late. Ball game is about 10 minutes underway now. Still in the top of the first, and I'll get the lineups for you in just 1 second.
As the wild coach, first pitch to Paul Molitor the other night when the Jays were in town.
Yep.
Curveball. Molitor will kiss him. It was going way outside and then hooked over the...
Okay. Sorry, everybody, for the delay. Game is underway, as I mentioned. Lineup starting for you today on the Royals mound is number 33 pitcher Matt Schmidt. Same pitchers we started with in our last home game just a couple weeks ago. Lineup for the Royals starting is number 2, Trevor Knipe, second baseman. Then third baseman, number 23, Kingsley Alarcon. Then right fielder, number 10, Chandler McLaren. Shortstop, number 7, Richard Gill. Then left fielder, number 5, Aaron Loader. Then first baseman, number 6, Brandon Power. Then center fielder, number 31, Tino Silvestri. Then designated hitter, number 21, Steven Satz. And then catcher, number 24, Salt Wheat. For the Toronto Maple Leafs, on the mound will be number 37, Dylan Mulholland. And first batter will be number 10, center fielder Grant Tamain. Then second baseman, number 6, Daniel Mara. Then right fielder, number 33, Jonathan Waltenbury. Then first baseman, number 17, Jonathan Salazzo. Then left fielder, number 27, Will Richards. Then shortstop, number 8, Sean Mattson. Then designated hitter, number 9, Justin Mara. Then catcher, number 24, Brendan Keyes. And then third baseman, number 3, Ryan White. We're still on the top of the first. Umpire's just going out to meet shortstop and pitcher in the middle of the infield. Didn't see what happened. I had my lineup in front of my face. But the count is 1-2, and there are two out and one man on. Just going to find out what happened there and what's going on in the infield. And that 1-2 count that I just mentioned was on a batter who just got an RBI double, so the score is now 1-0 for the Maple Leafs. And it sounds like what's going on in the infield right now, there was a steal attempt from second to third, and shortstop, I think, maybe third baseman, can't tell from here, caught him out, but he motioned that his wrist or his hand or something was hurting. Never mind, that's Matt Schmidt, that's the pitcher, and he's walking his way off of the field, so it sounds like he's just going to get a few pitches in today, and then we'll have someone else coming up fresh from the bullpen. No time to warm up. And coming up to replace Matt Schmidt on the mound, and he'll have lots of time to warm up here because it was an injury, is going to be number 48, Adrian Ewan. You know, for a second I thought the music that you can probably hear in the background there was coming from, today we have a pianist instead of a fiddler, unlike last time. I was wondering where the fiddler went. No word on that. Well, I thought that was him doing this until vocalist started, but no, I'm disappointed. But before the game, he was playing a lot of hits. He was playing the Pirates of the Caribbean theme song, which was pretty neat, I thought, as well as some Queen, and he played Hallelujah at one point, I'm pretty sure, as well. Adrian Ewan still warming up over on the mound.
Now pitching for the Royals, number 48, Adrian Ewan.
And here comes his first batter of the day.
This is Sean Manson. Will Richards.
And this will be number 27, left fielder Will Richards.
Batters number
batting left.
Will Richards.
Adrian sizing him up. Looking behind, watching the runner on second. Pitch will go low for ball one. Still watching that runner on second, keeping an eye on him. Next pitch on the outside of the box is going to be for strike one. Called. Adrian's still nervous about the runner. Next pitch swung on and hit. Bounced off the ground over to second base and a soft throw to first. I'll call it the end of the top of the first.
Top of the first, one run, one hit, no errors, one man left on base. There were two strikeouts, only three more to free wings with $5 purchase at Buffalo Wild Wings in Guelph. Fans, make sure you get your copy of the Royals Report. The Royals Report is your source for lucky numbers.
Side change now.
Team rosters, stats, and summaries of all the Guelph Royals action. Get your Royals Report for only $1 at the front gate.
And starting for the Guelph Royals will be number two, second baseman Trevor Knipe. Knipe, unfortunately, with no hits yet this season, although only in two games. Although that is in six at-bats. Hear what I mean by the pianist playing popular tunes? Still miss that fiddler, though. I wonder if maybe today we'll end up with a brawl on the field. We do have a Toronto team here, after all. Haven't seen a bat flip yet, but the game is young. Pitching for the Toronto Maple Leafs is number 37, Dylan Mulholland. And Trevor Knipe is on his way up to the mound. Plate, rather.
Leading off for the Royals in the bottom of the first, the second baseman, number 2, Trevor Knipe.
Batting left against a left-handed pitcher. Knipe digs in. Mulholland eyes him up. Quickly has his first pitch ready. High for ball one. Second pitch. Straight down the middle for a called strike one. Pitch number 3 way inside. Knipe had to move out of the way of that one, and it's 2-1. Mulholland adjusts his hat. Looks a little nervous about this. But he's ready with another pitch. Swung on and missed. The count is even at 2. Beautiful day out here for a game of baseball. It started out kind of cloudy this morning. I was worried we might get rained out. But it's really a beautiful day right now. Pitch swung on and missed, and that'll be a swinging strikeout. First one of the half for Mulholland. Next batter is third baseman number 23, Kingsley Alarcon. Alarcon is doing much better so far this season with an average of 510 at-bats. Three RBI. Batting right. Thought about swinging at that one, but it was low and outside for ball one. Called strike one. My mistake, not outside. Just on the corner. Way outside, ball one. Ball moves fast off of Mulholland's hand, but it seems to be a little bit wild so far today. He winds up. Swung on and hit hard, right on out to center field, between right and center, I should say. And that'll be a nice and solid single for Alarcon. He rounded first, thought about maybe running to see if there would be an error from the outfielder, but there was not. And it was picked up quickly. One out with one man on as we move on to right fielder number 10, Chandler McLaren. Left-handed versus left-handed. Alarcon with a great big leadoff. Mulholland doesn't seem too worried. He hasn't looked over at him once yet. There's the look. The pitch looked low, but it was hit hard and foul way off left, and that's going to bounce off of the roof of the center. 0-1. McLaren just had to adjust himself at the plate. Mulholland is going to take a look over at Knipe on first. The pitch will come in for a called strike two. McLaren ready for another. Mulholland still looking at Knipe on first. Runners going. There's a yell. And Knipe is going to be safe on second. Not even with a slide, but it was on a swinging strikeout. Now two out with one man on, as number 7, shortstop Richard Gill, comes up to the plate.
The batter, the right, the third baseman, number 7, Richard Gill.
I was wrong, he's the third baseman. Ball two, just outside. Ball one. called strike. That one, the umpire decided to mark down as a strike. Knipe still on second. Mulholland looking behind him. Pitch comes down, but way low, and that'll be ball two. The count is 2-1 with two out and one man on second. And that was Knipe's first hit of the season as well. Swinging strike on a pitch that was way inside. Count is even at two. Hit hard but foul along the first baseline. Count still even at two. Pitch hit really hard. That's going long. It doesn't clear the fence. That'll end inside. That's going to be at least one run. Indeed it will. That's an RBI double for third baseman number 7, Richard Gill. Game now tied at 1 in the bottom of the first. Now another left-handed batter, number 5, left fielder, Aaron Loader. Pitch high for ball 1. Mulholland keeping an eye on McLaren on second. Hit past the shortstop. It's going to be another run for the Guelph Royals, especially with the ball being fumbled over there by left fielder Jonathan Salazzo. An RBI single goes on the board for number 5 left fielder Aaron Loader.
Just a black coffee would be good.
Coffee? Yeah. Do you need anything? You good?
Mulholland attempted to get the runner out at first, but he was too quick. Brendan Power now at the plate. That's the first baseman. It's a 2-1 ball game right now in the bottom of the first with two out and one man on first. Count is 1-0. Another throw off to first, won't get the runner. Mulholland really trying to get the pickoff this time. Pitch way outside, an attempt to steal second, and a jump to catch the ball, but it's a safe steal, yet another steal for the Guelph Royals today. Power still at the plate, count is 2-0. Runner now on second. Must be getting on Mulholland's nerves. He looks behind him to check. Pitch hit hard straight out to center field, but it's bouncing before it gets there. A single for him, and another run in. Center fielder number 10, Grant Tamano, wasn't really sure what he was doing with the ball. He picked it up, but then decided not to throw, and then just a confusing time for him. It's now a 3-1 ball game. Still two out, one man on, an RBI single there.
The batter, the center fielder, number 31, Santino Silvestri.
Now at bat, another left-hander, number 31, center fielder, Tino Silvestri. First pitch way inside for ball 1. runners staying on first. No action in the bullpen yet from Toronto. Second pitch low for ball two. Runner still on first. That runner is now Brandon Power. Way outside for ball three. Two out, one man on first. That one right on down the middle for a called strike one. Mulholland not. Oh, there's the attention paid to the runner on first. Runner's going, but fouled straight back, and the runner's going to go back to first base. Power tried for that one. It's kind of tried and true so far this inning. It looks like you can steal second pretty much whenever you want to from Mulholland. Outside and walked. Now two out with two men on. Now batting number 21, designated hitter Steven Satz. Hit hard to shortstop. Inning finally ended now from the Toronto Maple Leafs with a quick throw to second for a force out. Waiting for the second inning to start. That was an exciting first one indeed, as the score is now 3-1. The Royals had four hits, Maple Leafs with no errors in that. Quite a few times second was stolen right out from under Dylan Mulholland, the first pitcher on the mound for the Toronto Maple Leafs. In the top of the first, the Leafs had one run with one hit. And they'll be starting at number 8, third baseman Sean Mattson, with Adrian Ewan still on the mound after partway through the first inning. Matt Schmidt is out with an injury. I've just been told that with the pitching change and whatnot, that came out to about a 35-minute first inning. That's very long. Very long indeed. Now in the top of the second, Toronto Maple Leafs hoping to close the gap. Of course, there's lots of game left for them to score two more.
Leading off for Toronto in the top of the second inning, the third baseman, number 8, Sean Mattson.
You heard the man, number 8, third baseman Sean Mattson leading off. Right-handed batter. Adrian sizing him up. Right-handed pitcher. First pitch comes in, hit really hard, but foul back. Over top of the stands and into my windshield.
You haven't learned yet. You don't park back there.
Oh, and one. Adrian not giving anything away from the mound. pitch hit hard. It was inside, but that's going long. Left field, but that's going to be caught for the first out by left fielder number 5, Aaron Loader. One of the men who got a hit last inning. RBI single.
Now batting the
Now batting number 9, designated hitter Justin Mara. Fouled off. The count is 0-2. 1-2. Pitch fouled into the plate. Still 1-2. Toronto Maple Leafs flag being flown. I think that's actually for the hockey team. Hit over to right field for a single. Now at bat number 24, the catcher, Brendan Keyes.
The batter, the catcher, number 24, Brendan Keyes.
One out with one man on first. Great big leadoff. Adrian going to look at him, but instead wind up for the pitch. Down the middle it goes, but it'll bounce. The hit bounces foul into the first base coach for the Maple Leafs. The count is 0-1. As Keyes steps up to the plate, gives it a tap. Adrian just looking at him. A look over to the first base runner. And here comes the pitch. Hit down the first baseline, bounces foul once more. Runner going to be sent back to first. But he got to second really fast. 0-2 with one out and one man on. Way outside for the first ball, 1-2. Swung on and missed for yet another strikeout to Adrian Ewan. Now two out, man still on first. Next batter is number 3, the shortstop, Ryan White.
The batter, the shortstop, number 3, Ryan White.
Right-handed this time. First pitch down the middle for a called strike one. Throw to first, not in time. And the runner stays safe. Adrian back on the mound. Check over the shoulder, but winding up for the pitch. Hit hard to center field. advances the runner to second for a solid single. Two out with two men on, first and second. Now back at the top of the Maple Leafs lineup with number 10, the center fielder, Grant Tamano. The count is 1-0. High for ball two. Runners ready at their bases. Adrian keeping an eye on the runner on second. Pitch is hit hard, but foul. First baseman not quite in time to catch that one. Two and one with two out. Still two men on. Temperature nice and mild, sun shining, but occasionally hiding behind the clouds. Really couldn't ask for much more for a game of baseball. The score is still 3-1. In the top of the second, two out with two men on. Fouled back into the net. Count even at two. If Tamani gets a hit here, it could well close up this gap for the Maple Leafs, but the pitch comes in way high and inside for ball three. Now a full count with two out and two men on, first and second. Runners advancing, and that'll be a walk to bases loaded. The batter now, second baseman number 6, Daniel Mara. Meeting over at the pitcher's mound, talking to Adrian about hopefully not letting the Maple Leafs close up this gap so early in the baseball game. It is currently 3-1 for the Guelph Royals.
The batter, the second baseman, number 6, Dan Mara.
Daniel Mara at the plate. Swung on that one. Just barely got a piece of it. The count is now 0-1. I am positive that Maple Leafs flag is for the hockey team. Second pitch, low and outside for ball one. Adrian keeping an eye on the runners. Pitch hit out to shortstop to second, and that'll be the end of the inning before the Maple Leafs can close up the gap. Still a 3-1 ball game.
For Toronto in the top of the second inning, no runs on two hits, no errors, and three men left on base. And we're now at three strikeouts with only two more to go to free wings with $5 purchase at Buffalo.
Toronto very close to closing up that gap I mentioned. If Daniel Mara had hit that ball even a little bit harder, it might have gone past the shortstop, and it might have been would have definitely been at least one run. Could even have become two to tie up the ball game. Instead, it was hit softly to shortstop, thrown softly to second for the end of the top of the second. Now in the bottom of the second, Mulholland's warming up. The score is still 3-1. The Royals will start at the bottom of their lineup with the catcher number 24, Saul Tweet. Tweet warming up over there. Right-handed batter for a left-handed pitcher. This ball could fly nice and far. Tweet with a .250 batting average and 4 at-bats this season. Looking to make that a .400. Tweet's walking up to the plate, and here comes the umpire with a pocket full of balls.
Leading off for the Royals in the bottom of the second, the catcher, number 24, Saul Tweet.
First pitch hit high and hard out to center field. And it will be caught for the first out of the inning. We've returned to the top of the lineup for the Royals, now batting second baseman number 2, Trevor Knipe.
The batter, the second baseman, number 2, Trevor Knipe.
First pitch, ball 1. Second pitch fouled back off of the catcher's helmet. The count is even at 1. Looked like it gave the catcher a little bit of a knock. Umpire checked to see if he was okay, but he got the nod, and play will continue. Outside and high for ball 2. Outside again and high, ball 3. The count is 3-1 for Trevor Knipe with 1 out and nobody on.
Nice.
Mulholland not giving anything away. Throws it in and a swinging strike 2. Swing was just a little bit high of the ball, but it was a big swing. Could have gone far if it made contact. Hit hard but fouled back. Sounds like it might have hit someone from the reactions of the crowd, or maybe someone's car. Full count with 1 out and nobody on. Crowd egging the batter on to swing, and he does, but it's flown out to center field. Now 2 out, nobody on. Now batting number 10, right fielder Chandler McLaren. My mistake, sorry, I skipped one. Number 23, shortstop Kingsley Alarcon.
Now batting shortstop, number 23, Kingsley Alarcon.
Hard pitch outside for ball one. Outside for ball two. Mulholland throwing a lot of balls today, allowed a lot of people to steal second in the first inning, but so far nobody's gotten on base to try it again. Winding up. Pitch comes down and hit even harder than the last one, once more out to center field, and that'll be it. Three up, three down for the Maple Leafs in the bottom of the second. The ball game is still 3-1 as we head into the top of the third.
No hits, no errors, and nobody left on base.
Heading into the top of the third, starting for the Maple Leafs will be number 33, right fielder Jonathan Waltenburg. Pitching for the Royals, still Adrian Ewan.
Thanks to the support of local businesses like these, the tradition continues in the Royal City.
Another chance for the Maple Leafs to close up this two-run gap. It is a 3-1 ball game after a largely uneventful top of the second, but a very exciting first inning indeed.
If you have Royals report number 316.
No Major League Baseball games underway just yet, but we've got a few starting at 10 after 2. That's about 15 minutes from now. The White Sox will visit the Royals, and the Twins visit the Blue Jays. Then at 3:05, this game may very well last long enough for you to hear at least the first or second inning of that. The Phillies visit the Braves. The third inning is now getting underway here at David E. Hastings Stadium. Starting for the Leafs, Jonathan Waltenbury, the right fielder.
Leading off for Toronto, the right fielder, number 33, John Waltenbury.
Still on the mound, Adrian Ewan. Called ball one. Second pitch is low for ball two. Adrian winds up and fires, just low and outside, ball three. Count is 3-0 with no out, nobody on, first batter of the inning. Hit hard, bounced off the first baseline, but goes foul. Now 3-1. A little bit of wind starting to roll in. Not too much to really affect gameplay, though a ball that's hit hard out towards right field might get blown a little bit back in. Way outside, wild pitch. Walks the first batter of the inning. Jonathan Waltenbury now on first. Now batting is first baseman number 17, Jonathan Salazzo.
The batter, the first baseman, number 17, John Salazzo.
First pitch goes in for strike one. Adrian eyeing up the runner on first. Readying the pitch. Low and outside for ball one. Hit hard out to right field. A single from that will advance the runner all the way to third. Coach tells him to hold there. Now batting left fielder number 27, Will Richards. With no out and two men on first and third, this is a really good scoring opportunity for the Leafs. But the first pitch goes high for ball one. Good number of Toronto fans in the crowd today. Of course, more Royals, though, it being a home game. That one hit to second base. Grounds for double play. And it indeed will be, but still a run comes in for the Maple Leafs, and they close the gap to just one run, now 3-2. Now Sean Mattson, third baseman, number 8. Two out, nobody on. Looked like that could have been outside, but the umpire says no, it was on the edge of the box, and that'll be called strike one. Hit just off of the third baseline, but goes foul for strike two. The count is 0-2 with two out and nobody on. The score, 3-2 after the Maple Leafs managed to close the gap just a little bit. Hit hard but foul, straight up and back into the crowd, which is just roaringly huge, by the way. Count still 0-2. Sean Mattson looking to get himself on base, set himself up for a score, perhaps from Justin Mara. Pitch comes in, hit hard out to right field. Goes foul. Almost caught, however, by McLaren, who was out there. He was only a little bit behind that. Not sure if that was influenced by that wind I mentioned earlier, or if it just happened to curve that way on its own. But the Maple Leafs bullpen has another ball to play with now. Ewan winds up. Pitch comes in hot, but outside for ball one. Pitch over the batter's head, ball two. Some action in the Guelph Royals bullpen. Can't tell who it is, but they've got someone warming up back there. Hit hard just past the pitcher. Shortstop not there in time. Center field won't make the throw, but will hold the runner at first. Now batting is number 9, designated hitter Justin Mara.
The batter, number 9, Justin Mara.
Hit hard and foul. First baseman gets under that to call it an inning.
One run, two hits, one left. Yep. For Toronto, one run on two.
One run that inning, two hits, and one man left on first.
And with that double play in that inning, we've got a winner with Shoeless Joe's. Every time the Royals turn a double play at home in 2016.
Into the bottom of the third, the score is 3-2 for the Guelph Royals after the Toronto Maple Leafs managed to score on a double play to close the gap by one.
Fans, the next home game for the Royals will be Holiday Monday here at Hastings Stadium.
Leading off for the Royals will be number 10, the right fielder Chandler McLaren.
Seven rivals, the Kitchener Panthers. Tickets can be purchased at the front gate today. Or on game days.
But first warming up on the mound,
with the Guelph Royals.
Still Mulholland. Starting for the Royals, number 10, right fielder Chandler McLaren. He makes his way up to the plate as Mulholland gets a good grip on the ball.
The right fielder, number 10, Chandler McLaren.
First pitch, outside for ball one. Second pitch was coming in inside the box, but was fouled back and left. Count even at one. Chandler needs to stretch. Mulholland getting a good grip on the ball as he decides on a pitch. Winds up. Fires it inside the box on the outside edge for a called strike two. Fourth pitch outside to even up the count at two. McLaren needs to take a second. Mulholland going to use the time to decide on a pitch. standing and waiting. Here it comes. For a called strikeout, Chandler McLaren goes down. Next up at bat is number 7, third baseman Richard Gill. One out, nobody on. Mulholland has really pulled his game together since that first inning where he allowed 3 runs.
The batter, the third baseman, number 7, Richard Gill.
An attempt at a bunt missed by Gill. That'll be strike 1. Next pitch comes inside for ball 1. Count is even at 1. Gill up on the mound, 1 out and nobody on. Here comes the pitch, way up high and outside for ball 2. Next pitch comes in quickly, fouled back into the fence. That looked like it could have hurt if someone had gotten hit by that one. Count is even at 2. Pitch comes in, but outside, ball 3. With a full count, 1 out and nobody on. Here comes the pitch, way outside. That walks Gill out to first. As number 5 left fielder, Aaron Loader, comes on. With 1 out and 1 man on first, Mulholland is in a familiar position, trying to keep men from stealing second from him as they did so many times back in the bottom of the first. Watching the pitcher, but throws the pitch. It's fouled back. Gill looked ready to run. Wild pitch goes outside for ball 1. Caught by the catcher, though, and Gill won't advance. A try for a pickoff almost was successful as Gill looked about ready to run, but he makes it back in time. Mulholland, nervous about the runner, throws it again, but Gill ready for it this time. The count is 1-1 with 1 out and 1 man on first. Mulholland watching that runner on first like a hawk. Throwing a pitch this time, the ball goes way on up high out to left field. Curves foul, almost caught by the left fielder, but won't be. Now 1-2. I think someone in the crowd has one of those handheld clapper things that you shake back and forth and makes the clapping sound. Yeah, that's what that is. Pitch outside for ball 2. The count is now 2-2. I remember using one of those clapper things when I was a kid to annoy my parents to the point that they actually threw it in the garbage. Sad day in my life. Runner advancing. Pitch was outside for a ball, and the runner makes it to second on time. Yet another stolen base from Mulholland. His coach is going to have a word or two for him at the end. of the game. Full count. Hit out to center field, way up high. Shortstop getting under that as it curves over to left, and that will be the second out of the inning. Two out with a man on second. As number six, first baseman Brendan Power comes up to the plate.
The batter, the first baseman, number six, Brendan Power.
Two out, one man on. Here comes the first pitch. Hit out to second, but and he does slide, gets there in time. Looked like he wasn't going to, and the runner will be safe on first just by a hair, but the umpire calls that one safe. And that advances the runner to third.
Batting the center fielder, number 31, Santino Silvestri.
Next batter is number 31, Tino Silvestri, the center fielder. Great opportunity for him here. If he can just get a base hit, it'll be an RBI for him for sure. First pitch goes in for a called strike one. Second pitch swung on and fouled back. I'm sure you heard that bang. That was it hitting the roof over my head. The count is 0-2 with two out and men on first and third. Swung on and fouled to right. Tino staying alive at the plate. Runner advancing to second. Ball caught, but the throw goes past the second baseman, and the man on third will advance to make this a 4-2 ball game. Not the best steal attempt there from the first base runner, but probably worth it.
First error of the game, yeah?
And that goes up as the first error of the game. And it goes up for the Maple Leafs as the throw was missed by the second baseman. That pitch hit straight to the second baseman to call it an end for the bottom of the third. And it's now a 4-2 ball game for the Guelph Royals over the Toronto Maple Leafs.
In the bottom of the third, one run, one hit, one error, and one man left on base. Fans, it's time for Domino's delivery of the game. If you have lucky number 3-2-5.
Moving into the top of the fourth, the Maple Leafs are back down to a two-run deficit after having closed it to 3-2 in the top of the third. Leading off the top of the fourth for the Maple Leafs will be number 24, their catcher, Brendan Keyes.
Tickets are $2 each or 3 for $5. The 50-50 draw will be made at the end of the seventh inning.
Well, Dallas got ejected in the first half of the first inning.
Adrian Ewan still on the mound as we start things in the fourth. Leading off in the top of the fourth, number 24, the catcher, Brendan Keyes. Ewan makes his way up to the mound, looks around, checks his field.
Any difference over there?
First pitch, hit but fouled past the first baseline. Adrian gives really nothing away on that mound. In comes the pitch. It's hit over to the second baseman. Should be no problem. And indeed it isn't for the first out of the inning. Next at the plate is number 3, Ryan White, the shortstop.
Now batting the shortstop, number 3, Ryan White.
First pitch to White is inside for ball one. Next pitch outside, ball two. Adrian setting up. Winds and fires, but comes inside for ball three. First strike is called as it comes in the top of the box. The count is 3-1 with no outs and nobody on. Last pitch goes way inside, almost hit White, and it'll walk him out to first.
Center fielder, number 10, Grant.
Now back to the top of the Maple Leafs lineup, number 10, center fielder, Grant Tamani. With no out and one man on, good opportunity for the Leafs here. That one stays high and outside for ball one. Throw to the runner at first, not in time. Adrian eyeing up the runner again. Throws a pitch. It's hit out to second baseman, but not hard enough for that to be a double play, but it is still the second out of the inning. Now batting number 6, second baseman Daniel Mara.
Tell the immediate difference there, man.
Yeah, I know.
What reached a point? First pitch just down in the bottom right corner of the box for a called strike one.
I heard a difference myself as we went along there.
What if that mic's the problem?
Dan up at the plate as Adrian eyes up the runner, now on second. Ball is hit way foul, but is caught by the third baseman way past the foul line to draw an end to the top of the fourth. No runs, no hits, one man left on second after that inning. Leading off for the Royals in the bottom of the fourth will be number 21, the designated hitter, Steven Satz.
Milestones, Barberino's, Domino's Pizza, Montana's, Palmer's Cleaners, M&T Printing, and Brad Barber at the Cooperators. The Guelph Royals.
Still Dylan Mulholland on the mound. They're letting him keep going. And there's no action that I can see in their bullpen. The Maple Leafs pitching coaches, anyway, seem okay with Dylan allowing so many second bases being stolen, as well as the run deficit. MLB score update for you. Both of those games I mentioned have now started. The White Sox are visiting the Kansas City Royals, not the Guelph Royals. It'd be very exciting if they were here, but they're not. They're in Kansas. It is 1-0 for the Royals in the bottom of the first. Twins are visiting the Jays. It's the top of the second, and the score is tied at 0. In about an hour's time, the Phillies will start against the Braves. Walking up to the plate is number 21 designated hitter, Steven Satz, who will lead things off for the Royals here in the bottom of the fourth. The score is 4-2 as the Maple Leafs were once again unable to close the gap. Mulholland getting ready on the mound as he sizes Sats up. Decides quickly on his first pitch. Out it comes. Just inside the box on the far side for a called strike one. Second pitch equally fast for a swinging strike two. Mulholland knows exactly what he's doing, not keeping the batters waiting at all. That one swung on and fouled down into the plate. That one hit hard directly to the pitcher, and the throw to first is on time to make it the first out of the bottom of the fourth. Now batting number 24, catcher Saul Tweet. Bottom of the lineup, first pitch comes in inside the box for a called strike one.
I just turned everything off again to see if it resets and wakes itself back up here.
Pitch comes in for called strike two. The count is 0-2 with one out and nobody on. Next pitch comes inside for ball one. Mulholland not putting as much pressure on Tweet as he was Sats, but the pitchers are still coming out pretty quickly, although that one went high and outside for ball two, and the count is now even at two. Wild pitch goes outside for ball three. With a full count and one out, nobody on, Tweet stands really could use the hit now. Swings on that one. Great big swing, but can't manage to get a piece of it, and that'll be a strikeout for him. Back to the top of the Royals lineup with number two, the second baseman, Trevor Knipe.
Trevor Knight.
That sounded loud.
Yeah.
First pitch inside and high for ball one. Called strike one. That pitch goes down the middle, was swung on but missed for strike two. The count is now 1-2 with two out and nobody on as Trevor Knipe hopes to change how this inning is going. Hoping to keep it from being 3-up, 3-down. Next pitch comes in, but just high, says the umpire, to make it 2 balls. Pitch just outside for ball three. The count is now full. This could be the last pitch of the inning. Knipe lines things up. Mulholland wastes no time and winds up and fires. Here comes the pitch. Swung on and missed for a swinging strike three by Trevor Knipe. That'll be 3-up, 3-down for Mulholland as we head into the top of the 5th inning. And leading things off for the Maple Leafs will be Jonathan Salazzo, the first baseman, number 17.
Stone's one of Guelph's favorite eateries on Stone Road is offering a gift certificate package to the following Royals report number 269. 269.
The game is still 4-2 for the Royals as we have a bit of a pattern forming. First inning, the Maple Leafs scored one run right off the bat with an RBI double. But the Royals answered with 3 runs. Then a scoreless second inning led into a third inning with 1 score for both teams. And now a scoreless 4th takes us into the top of the 5th as the Maple Leafs are faced once again with a 2-run deficit. Adrian Ewan will continue pitching into the top of the 5th, and he is the second pitcher for the Royals so far today, as partway through the first inning, number 33, Matt Schmidt, went out with an injury. An update from other IBL action. Brantford is leading Hamilton 3-1 right now, and Kitchener leads Burlington 8-0. Pretty impressive score from Kitchener there, although no surprises, it is the Kitchener Panthers after all.
Toronto in the top of the 5th, the right fielder, number
kicking things off will be right field number 33, Jonathan Waltenbury. Adrian slower with pitches than Mulholland was. First pitch goes outside for ball one. Next pitch called for strike one. Waltenbury taking his time at the plate. Adrian wastes no time once he's ready. Hit hard to first, and the pitcher makes it well in time for the first out of the inning. Now batting number 17, first baseman Jonathan Salazzo.
The batter, the first
A bit of a poor effort from Waltenbury there after he hit it out to first. He barely even ran. He just kind of jogged to make it look like he was heading in the right direction and just allowed the play to be made. Solazzo up at the plate. Adrian winds up and fires. Goes just outside of the box for ball one. Next pitch comes in hard for a swinging strike one. The count is 1-1 with one out and nobody on base. Pitch outside for ball two. Adrian really taking his time setting up these pitches. That one comes in, gets fouled back, and off of the roof of the grandstands. The count is even at two with one out and nobody on. Solazzo sets up at the plate. Adrian fires yet another one way outside for ball three to fill up the count. Adrian's starting to look a little bit tired over on the mound. He's taking his time setting up the pitches, and a lot of them are going way outside. Some action in the bullpen, though. Looks like they're starting to warm up his replacement, but he does manage to get a swinging strikeout there right as I talk about how tired he's looking. In comes the second out of the inning. Now batting number 27 left fielder Will Richards.
That's four strikeouts.
That's not working. There you go.
The batter number 27, Sean Manson.
That one hit hard to second base. Easy throw to first. As Will Richards sees the third out. And we head into the bottom of the fifth.
No runs, no hits, no errors, and nobody left on base. That's four strikeouts, one.
Three up, three down for Adrian Ewan, even though he's starting to look a little bit tired. A lot of balls hit out to first base or to the pitcher. Leading off the bottom of the fifth for the Guelph Royals will be the shortstop number 23, Kingsley Alarcon. Alarcon, another one of the people on the team who has some hits on the board so far this season, with a 500 average and 10 at-bats, and 3 RBI. Sorry, 2 RBI. 3 runs. Still no pitching changes from either team. It looks like Mulholland will have yet another go at things, as he hopes to keep the Royals off of his bases because they keep stealing them once they get on there.
Fans, it's time for some lucky Royals report numbers. Again, if you have the lucky number 310, you've won a pair of Guelph Royals game tickets. You can claim your prize from Patty at the front gate, 310.
Kingsley warming up, a really big swing over there in the on deck. Makes a slow walk up to the plate as Mulholland gets ready on the mound.
Leading off for the Royals, the shortstop, number 23, Kingsley Alarcon.
Mulholland slower with the pitches than he was last inning. Here comes the first one. Low for ball one. Another pitch low, but swung on and missed by Kingsley for strike one. Another low pitch swung on and missed to make the count 1-2 for Kingsley Alarcon. Next pitch hit, bounces off the ground, goes to the glove of the third baseman, and it will be in time to make the first out of the inning as Kingsley isn't quite on time to the first base. Now at bat number 10, right fielder Chandler McLaren.
The batter, the right fielder, number 10, Chandler McLaren.
Chandler gets a grip on the bat. Mulholland wastes no time. Much faster with this one. First pitch comes in but goes outside for ball one. Swung on and just tipped back for strike one. That pitch was inside. Chandler stretching a little bit before play resumes. And Mulholland winds up. Pitch comes in just above the zone. Ball two. Pitch outside, ball three. The count is 3-1 with one out and nobody on. Next pitch, low but inside the zone, says the umpire, for a called strike two. Pitch was low but probably in the zone as it's fouled back and left. Mulholland sets a few new divots in the mound for himself. Chandler sets up on the plate. Pitch comes in, fouled way left this time, probably into the parking lot. Pitch was high that time, but swung on and hit. It'll go foul as it crosses the third baseline and into the glove of third baseman Sean Mattson. Now batting third baseman number 7, Richard Gill.
The batter, the third baseman, number 7, Richard Gill.
First pitch fouled back. Second pitch comes in. Looked a little outside of the box, but inside, says the umpire, for a called strike two. Pitch is low for ball one. Mulholland is trying to rush Gill on this one. Seems to be working for him so far. Pitch way inside, ball two. Mm-hmm. That one hit hard out to right field, but it crosses the line and it will be foul. The count is 2-2. Two out and nobody on. Fouled again. Richard Gill staying alive out there on the plate. Just fouling him off until he gets a good one. Here comes the pitch. Way outside for ball three to fill up the count with Richard Gill. Gill walked once back in the third. Looks like it might be the same again for him now in the fifth. And indeed it will be. Gill walked for the second time this game as he moves on down to the first base. Now at bat number five, the left fielder, Aaron Loader. Mulholland watching Gill like a hawk, trying to pick him off because both times he's been out there, he's been trying to steal the first time he did so successfully. And away he goes, trying it this time, but it's not going to work. And he'll be called out, and that'll be that for the inning. 99 pitches from Dylan Mulholland now this game. Was looking forward to calling it 100 this bottom of the fifth, but didn't get to. We'll see just how far over the 100 mark his coaches will let him get.
Each and every day to help you continue to look your best. Barberino's, located on Woolwich, just 3 minutes from Hastings Stadium, is donating a complimentary certificate if you have Royals report number 301. You win today's style.
As we wait for the side change, starting for the Maple Leafs will be number 8, the third baseman, Sean Mattson. Adrian Ewan will continue to pitch from the mound. I've got an update for you from Major League Baseball. Royals still lead the White Sox in the bottom of the second, while the Jays have managed to score 2 in the bottom of the third and lead the Twins 2-0. Sean Mattson on his way up to the plate now. Toronto still with a 2-run deficit they hope to make up this inning after the last 2 innings have been scoreless for both teams. The score is 4-2. First pitch comes in fast but high for ball 1. Fouled hard along the third base line. The count is 1-1. Adrian sets up, winds, fires, and it goes straight down the middle, hit hard to shortstop, and the throw is going to be in time for the first out of the inning. Now batting number 9, designated hitter Justin Mara. And on deck is number 24, the catcher Brandon Keys. Mattson trying for something similar that from what he got back in the third as he hit himself a single. But it's a no-go, says the shortstop. Mara digs in. Adrian watches. First pitch outside for ball one. Second way outside, ball two. Adrian trying to pull one over on Justin Mara. Doesn't work so well. Next pitch is low, bounces off of the ground for ball three. The count is 3-0 with one out and nobody on now. Justin Mara hoping to get himself another base hit. Last pitch comes inside. No base hit for Mara, but he does get himself a walk. Now batting is number 24, catcher Brandon Keys. On deck is number 3, shortstop Ryan White.
The batter, the catcher, number 24, Brandon Keys.
Outside and low for ball one. Mara decides not to run, but he had a great big leadoff. Again, no run, but outside for ball two. Outside ball three. Adrian really starting to show that he didn't get much time to warm up before he was put up on the mound. And outside it will go for his second walk of the inning. Now one out with men on first and second as we move down to the bottom of the lineup with number 3 shortstop Ryan White on his way up to the plate. A meeting over at the mound. Something to be expected. And as that meeting draws to an end, Adrian stays on the mound, but I suspect not for too much longer, as I can see definitely two pitchers warming up in the bullpen.
The batter, number 3, Ryan White.
Ryan White now on the plate. With one out and men on first and second, Adrian has a lot to worry about and a lot to think about. Pitch goes right on down the middle for called strike one. Another one, this time over in the right side for called strike two. Ryan White with a count of 0-2. He can afford to lose this one, but swinging at one of them would probably be a wise choice. Hit hard right into the glove of the third baseman. The throw would have been in time to second base, but the shortstop or second baseman misses it, and the runner actually advances up to third. First error for the Royals. Now two out with none on first and third. And we're back to the top of the lineup for the Maple Leafs. Center fielder, number 10, Grant Tamani. Pitch goes way outside and low for ball one. Hit hard, almost into the glove of the third baseman again. He dove for it, but wasn't there in time. And the left fielder throws it out to shortstop to hold the runners. A run comes in now for the Maple Leafs, as it's a 4-3 ball game.
The batter, the second baseman, number 6, Dan Mara.
Now batting second baseman number 6, Daniel Mara, with two outs and men on first and second. Pitch inside for ball one. That pitch hit hard out to left field. He can't get under it just in time. Runners rounding the third base. Pitch over to the plate, and he's not quite in time with the turnaround. And that'll be the tying run for the Toronto Maple Leafs. It's now a 4-4 baseball game after a strong hit out to left field. The Royals have their work cut out for them now. Now batting is number 33 right fielder Jonathan Waltenbury.
The batter, the right fielder, number 33, John Waltenbury.
Another meeting at the mound. May very well be it for Ewan. That's two runs this inning. Two men walked. Hands the ball over and away he will go. On his way out of the bullpen now. Nobody knows who this pitcher is. Ryan Greco, number 44.
Does that sound right?
Yes, it is.
Maple Leafs have successfully closed the gap. It's now a 4-4 ball game here in the bottom of the sixth. Sorry, top of the sixth. Just watching Ryan Greco do his warm-up pitches. He's a lot more animated than Adrian Ewan was, definitely much better to watch. Pitches have been going a little bit wild, but he's only just gotten himself up there now. And they move fast, they pack a lot of a punch. Make a great smack sound when the catcher gets it. With men on first and second, play resumes. Batting is right fielder number 33, Jonathan Waltenbury. Two outs, men on first and second. Pitch just high for ball one. Second pitch is low for ball two. Pitch was right down the middle, but hit hard and high by Waltenbury out to left field. And into Loader's glove it will go. And it's still a 4-4 ball game as we head into the bottom of the sixth inning.
For Toronto on the top of the sixth, two runs, two hits, one error, and two men left on base.
Moving into the bottom of the sixth, leading things off will be the same left fielder who caught that fly ball, Aaron Loader. Our pianist is playing the theme song to Game of Thrones now. He's been all over the place. And now Star Wars. That's funny. He's been playing so many show tunes all day today. Some songs that you and I would know. Some concert tunes. Pretty sure I heard some Beethoven down there earlier. Still on the mound, getting ready for his 100th pitch of the game, Dylan Mulholland. First up at bat will be number 5, Aaron Loader, the left fielder. And he is now on his way up. First batter of the bottom of the sixth inning. The Royals really have their work cut out for them now after they lost their 4-2 lead. First pitch. Inside for ball one. Mulholland taking his time a little bit with this one. Pitch comes in, swung on and fouled back for strike one. Pitch just in the outside of the box for strike two called. Next pitch went high but hit hard, lined straight into the shortstop's glove for out number one of the inning. Now batting number 6, first baseman Brendan Power. First pitch way inside, nearly brushed against Power's uniform for ball one. Hit really hard, great big crack of the bat, but it goes far and foul into the trees past the first baseline. I think he may actually have broken the bat there. Doesn't really look like it, but he's going to get a new one. Count is now 1-1. Swung on. Great big swing. This one missed for strike two. Swung on and missed once more. That'll be strike three. Two outs, no men on, no hits, no nothing so far this inning. Now batting is number 31 center fielder Tino Silvestri. First pitch swung on and missed. Despite having been up on the mound for so long, Mulholland is staying pretty strong. As long as he can keep the players off of base, he seems to be pretty all right. Pitch goes into the top left corner of the zone for strike two. That one hit fairly softly over to second base, and the throw's in time to first to draw the bottom of the sixth inning to an end. Leading off the seventh inning for the Toronto Maple Leafs will be Jonathan Salazzo. Pitching will be Ryan Greco. He only had one at-bat last inning. And the game is still tied up at four.
Here's today's winning 50-50 ticket number 0297. 0297. Please report to the concession stand to claim your winnings. That was ticket number 0297. Thanks for supporting the Guelph Royals baseball and the Knights of Columbus.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Making his way up to the plate now, number 17, first baseman Jonathan Salazzo.
Leading off in the top of the seventh inning, the first baseman, number 17.
The score is tied up at four, as Ryan Greco hopes to keep the bases empty. First pitch outside for ball one. Next pitch comes in, curves in just at the last second, goes low, and it'll be called strike one. Greco proving himself to be a bit of a tricky pitcher, as he throws those balls pretty hard, but that one goes low for ball two. Third pitch low, fourth for ball three. The count is 3-1 for this first batter of the seventh inning. Pitch goes just outside, says the umpire, and that'll be a walk. Now batting number 27, left fielder Will Richards.
The batter, the left fielder, number 27, Will Richards.
Greco takes a look, winds up. Fires it in just high for ball one. Salazzo thought about running but changed his mind. Next pitch swung on and missed for strike one. Salazzo making up his mind. He's got it. Makes the pitch. Throws it fast but goes way inside. Ball two. Doesn't look too happy with himself for that one. I think he was hoping for it to go a little further away from the batter. Pitch way inside, almost hit the batter. Runner advancing to second as the catcher missed it. The count is now 3-1 with no out and one man on second base. Greco digs in. Throws it hard for a called strike two just on the far side of the zone. Of the box, sorry. Full count with no out and a man on second base. Greco winds up. Checks over his shoulder once first. Makes the pitch, but it goes way up high for another walk. Now no out with men on first and second. Catcher headed to the mound to have a chat with his pitcher, while number 8, third baseman Sean Mattson, makes his way up to the plate. Maple Leafs really stand to make a big comeback here now late in the game. They were trailing 3-1 after the first inning, then 4-2 after the third. Couldn't make anything up, but now here we are in the top of the seventh, and the score is tied 4-4, and there are no outs and men on first and second, and halfway through the lineup. Mattson takes a swing, fouls it way on back over top of the grandstands, and it'll land somewhere in the parking lot. Next pitch hit equally hard, pops it up, it's foul over by the first baseline, and the first baseman gets under it to make it the first out of the inning. Now batting number 9, designated hitter Justin Mara. Now one out, still with men on first and second. Greco decides what he's going to do, winds it up, checks over his shoulder, decides to make the pitch instead. First pitch is called for strike one up in the outside corner of the box. Next pitch comes in. It was low, but swung on and missed. Catcher missed it. Runner makes a break for it to third, but he was slow on the decision, but the throw is missed. Runner rounds third base, he'll cross the plate, and it's now a 5-4 ball game. Now a 5-4 ball game for the Maple Leafs. And the runner on first advanced to second. Greco getting ready for this pitch. Throws it in. It's hit really hard, way up high. Foul over the third baseline this time. Third baseman gets under it, and that'll be the second out of the inning. Now batting the catcher, number 24, Brendan Keyes. First pitch just outside for ball one. With a runner on second, this is a really good opportunity for the Toronto Maple Leafs to extend their lead by one more. Next pitch comes in nice and hot, but high for ball two. Greco doesn't seem too happy with what's gone on this inning. Throws it in, throws it hard, hit foul way off, probably bounced off of the wall of the community center out here. Count now 2-1. Greco, seeming not too worried about the runner on second, throws in a nice swinging strike to even up the count at two, with two outs and a man on second, trying to keep it down to one run this inning. Another one fouled off into the stands. Keyes trying to stay alive, trying to be picky about what he hits. Greco still not too concerned about the runner on second. Throws it in, fouled off once more. Staying alive at the plate. Fouled back. No slam must have cleared its way over the grandstands and made it into the parking lot. The count is even at two with two outs and a man over on second. Swung on and missed for a strikeout for Greco after staying alive for so long. Brendan Keyes couldn't quite do it. The score is 5-4 for the Toronto Maple Leafs. Leading off the bottom of the seventh will be designated hitter number 21, Steven Satz. Mulholland still pitching. Checking in on today's Major League Baseball scores, now three games underway. The Royals lead the White Sox 1-0, while the Jays lead the Twins 2-0 in the bottom of the fifth, and the Braves and Phillies are still scoreless in the bottom of the first.
Domino's Fresh Pizza, 3-2-5. Milestones gift certificate 269, and the Barbarino gift certificate number 301. Time for the seventh inning stretch.
And we are now in the seventh inning stretch. We'll be right back after a very short break. And we are back here in the seventh, bottom of the seventh inning. The count is 3-2 with the leadoff batter, number 21, designated hitter, Steven Satz. And that'll be a walk for him as he makes his way over to first base, still pitching for the Maple Leafs, Dylan Mulholland. 116 pitches, says the scorekeeper next to me. I wonder when they'll retire him. Actually, probably pretty soon. I can see someone warming up over in the Maple Leafs bullpen now. Now batting number 24, the catcher, Saul Tweet. Goes for the bunt, but he misses it. But apparently the bat didn't come far enough around, so that'll be ball one. The attempted pickoff throw over to first base is nowhere near in time, as Sots barely even had a leadoff. Pitch comes in, successful bunt goes right down the third baseline and eventually crosses it to become a foul ball. Well played by the third baseman. He almost picked it up to try to make the throw off to first, but instead he backed off and let it cross the line to become foul. The count is even at one with no outs and a man over on first at the bottom of the Royals lineup. Throw comes in, low but inside the box, says the umpire, right in the middle for a called strike two. Pickoff throw to first, not in time. Mulholland really doesn't trust these players once they get on there, but despite all this mistrust and attempted pickoffs, he's only been able to stop one attempted steal. Pitch comes in, hit really hard out to center field, should be no problem to catch that, and indeed he will to send the runner back to first base. Now at the top of the lineup, batting is second baseman number 2, Trevor Knight. With one out and a man still on first, Knipe is in a good position to fill up the bases here. Another pitch right in the bottom of the box for a called strike one. Mulholland still checking that first base runner. And makes a very obvious pickoff. Once again, not in time. Knipe ready at the plate. Pitch comes in, but it's outside for ball one. Mulholland deciding on a pitch, watching the runner at first. Makes the pickoff throw again. Sats looks like he's starting to get a little bit tired of having to walk back and forth so much. Knipe ready at the plate. Mulholland on the mound. Watching that runner still. Makes a pitch. Swung on and missed by Knipe. 1-2. Really reached for that time by Knipe. He was just a little bit too eager. Outside for ball two. Count is now 2-2 with one out and a man still on first. Mulholland really keeping that runner under wraps. Watching him. Makes the pitch, but it goes way outside to fill up the count. With a full count and only one out, Trevor Knipe can really afford to take a swing at this one. But he won't do, makes a good call as it goes low, and he'll be walked out to first to put two men on base. Now batting is number 23, shortstop Kingsley Alarcon. And it looks like Mulholland might be being sent away, meeting up at the mound. We'll see. They might give him a little bit more of this inning before they take him off. And indeed, he will stay. But that was probably them telling him he's on his way out. Batting is number 23, shortstop Kingsley Alarcon, with one out and men on first and second after two consecutive walks. Hit hard, way out between left and center fields, both people running over to catch it, and it'll land in the glove of left fielder, who's going to throw it out to third just to be sure. Keep those runners stayed put. Now batting right fielder, number 10, Chandler McLaren. With two out and two on, Chandler could fill in this one-run deficit. It is now a 5-4 ball game for the Maple Leafs and could even stand a really good hit, could actually put them ahead by one. Pitch comes in, swung on and missed for strike one. Pitch just barely makes its way into the top left corner of the box. Looked like it would have been going high from Chandler's perspective for called strike two. Chandler now 0-2 with two out and men on first and second. Way inside, Chandler had to dodge that one, ball one. Pitch outside, ball two. Catcher was ready to make the throw for an attempted steal there, but neither players wanted it. Count is 2-2 with two out, two men on. Pitch comes in, fouled back into the net. Mulholland still safe out there on the mound. This could be his last inning, though. Hit hard right between center and right fields. This will be at least one RBI for him. He rounds the bases. He goes to second. Changes his mind. He'll back up and stay on first for an RBI single. McLaren ties up the game in the bottom of the seventh. It's now a 5-5 baseball game. And coming up to bat is number 7 third baseman Richard Gill with two out and men on first and third. And despite this, Mulholland remains on the mound. First pitch in the low corner of the box for a called strike one. Swung on and missed for strike two. Richard Gill doesn't want to go out on this one like that. Looking for a hit. 0-2 with two out and two men on. Swing and a miss, and that'll be strike three for the end of the seventh inning. But not a bad inning at all, as the Royals were able to answer the one run by the Maple Leafs that put them ahead in the top of the seventh with one more. And it's now a 5-5 ball game. The Maple Leafs lead off the eighth inning with shortstop number three, Ryan White, at the bottom of their lineup. Pitching for the Royals shall remain number 44, Ryan Greco. The Maple Leafs thought they had it in the bag, top of the seventh, score one to make it a 5-4 baseball game, and they couldn't quite keep the Royals away from that plate. Now 5-5. Fat Lady ain't singing. We got two innings to go, and the score is tied. Now up at the plate, number three, shortstop, Ryan White. First pitch on the inside edge of the box for called strike one. Tricky pitch from Greco there. Greco wasting no time for another pitch, but it goes low, ball one. Another try at making that inside pitch for a calling strike, but it was just too far inside. Ball two. Taking his time a little more with that one. Greco throws it, but it goes way outside, successfully tricked White, and he swings at that one for strike two. Now 2-2. Pitch was going inside, but he hits it hard out to left field. He's going to get at least two bases out of this. Never mind. Ryan decides he's not fast enough for that, and a really strong throw to shortstop from left field makes him stay over at first. Now back at the top of the lineup, center fielder number 10, Grant Tamani. No out, man on first. Greco thinking seriously about what he wants to do with this. First one goes out, but it bunts straight on up. Catcher gets under it. First out of the inning. Now second baseman number 6, Daniel Mara. One out, one man on at the top of the Leafs lineup. Pitch tricked the batter, called strike on the outside edge of the box. Tricking the batter again. Pitch moved around a little bit through the air, but found its way to the inside edge of the box for called strike two. That pitch went low, ball one. That one hit hard, straight out to center field. He'll get under it and send the runner back to first. Now two outs. Ryan White still on first. Pinch hitter stepping in for number 33, John Waltenbury, the right fielder, is number 31, Troy Daring. First pitch goes foul past the first baseline. Second one fouled back. Greco taking his time with that pitch, but it goes outside for ball one. Pitch was high, but hit hard out to center field. And Silvestri gets under it once more to draw the first half of the eighth to a close. One hit, one man left on base.
For Toronto at the top of the eighth, no runs, one hit, no errors, and one man left on base.
Just waiting for the warm-ups now as we go into the bottom of the eighth. Score still tied up at 5. Looks like the Maple Leafs are leaving Mulholland up on the mound a little while longer. What was that, 137 pitches you said? 137 pitches for him so far this game. Gotta be a tired arm, but guess not too tired yet. No changes in the Major League scores so far. It's 1-0 for the Royals over the Chi Sox in the bottom of the fifth. 2-0 for the Jays over the Twins in the top of the seventh. And still tied at 0 in the top of the third, Braves and Phillies.
Leading off for the Royals at the bottom of the eighth, the left fielder, number 5, Aaron Loader.
Aaron Loader now, left fielder number 5. Inside for ball 1. Next pitch goes right down the middle, but swung on and missed for strike 1. Way outside for that pitch, ball 2. Pitch outside, ball 3. Now 3-1, Aaron Loader. Umpire says he broke the plane. The bat went far enough round for that to be a strike, and it's now 3-2 on a pitch that went outside. Another throw from Mulholland, and Loader does get a piece of it for a foul, now 3-2. Hit hard to second baseman, throw to first on time and in place for the first out of the inning. Well played by Daniel Mara. Good throw to first baseman Jonathan Salazzo. Now batting number 6, first baseman Brandon Power.
The batter, the first baseman, number 6, Brandon Power.
Right down the middle, swung on and missed for strike 1. Giving home plate a good old tap. Mulholland still wasting no time, still got lots of energy, and he fouls that one way off into the parking lot. The count is 0-2 with one out and nobody on. Score is still tied at 5 in the bottom of the 8th inning. Hit down the third baseline, bounces a few times along the ground, but a strong throw from third baseman number 8, Sean Mattson, straight to first baseman Jonathan Salazzo, will make it out number 2. Now batting number 31, center fielder Tino Silvestri. Silvestri made a couple good catches last inning, making 2 of 3 outs.
Number 31, Santino Silvestri.
First pitch in no time. Low for ball 1. That one was low, but inside the box for a called strike 1. Mulholland knows what he's doing. He knows how to pitch these guys. Comes out, swung on, way inside, but it was a swing, strike 2. That was a hard pitch for someone who's got that many pitches. And another one, swung on and hit hard out to right field. Will they be able to make the catch? Indeed they will. That's 3 outs. That's it for the 8th inning. We'll go into the 9th, still tied up at 5, and opening for the Maple Leafs will be Jonathan Salazzo, their first baseman.
For the Royals in the bottom of the 8th, no runs, no hits, no errors, nobody left on base.
So how many pitches now? Probably 150-something.
Heading into the 9th inning. Greco makes his way out to the mound once more. A strong pitcher, that one. Guelph hoping to keep the Maple Leafs off of the bases just long enough to get into the bottom of the 9th so they can clean this up. It's been a very close ball game so far today. First inning saw it 3-1 in favor of Guelph after RBI double from the Toronto Maple Leafs and then some very strong plays from the Guelph Royals. Scoreless second took us into the third inning where both teams scored one. Toronto thought they were closing the gap, but Guelph answered with one more. Then two scoreless innings into the top of the sixth, where Toronto actually took the lead 5-4 with two runs after a couple of walks that resulted in Adrian Ewan being sent off the mound. Guelph couldn't answer that inning, but then one more from Toronto in the top of the eighth, top of the seventh, answered by same from Guelph, took us to a 5-5 ballgame. Just warming up now, waiting for mid-lineup Maple Leafs to come up here. Jonathan Salazzo, their first baseman, will lead things off. On deck is Will Richards, left fielder number 27, and following him, number 8, the third baseman, Sean Mattson. Sean made a very strong play last inning. Ball hit softly out to him. Runner could have made it to first on time if Mattson had been much slower and not made such a strong throw. But a strong throw out to first, right where it should have been, closed up the inning. Salazzo makes his way up to the plate now. Greco ready to pitch him.
Leading off for Toronto at the top of the ninth, the first baseman, number 17, John Salazzo.
First pitch, low for ball one. Outside left corner of the box that time, called strike one. Swung on and fouled down off the plate for strike two. Greco throwing the balls hard this time, trying to keep the batters on their toes. Foul tipped again off the ground. Strike two. The count is 1-2 for this first batter at the top of the ninth, Jonathan Salazzo. Greco still on top of his game. Winds up, fires one down, hit hard to first base. He gets there in time. Is the pitcher going to make it there first? Instead, first base slides over, and he's not in time. A safe call from the umpire says that the runner was there before him. Crowd doesn't seem to agree with that one. Jonathan Salazzo is safe on first. But Royal staff is going over to talk to the first base umpire about that one. Upheld, no out. One man on first. Now batting number 27, Will Richards, left fielder.
Now batting the left fielder, number 27, Will Richards.
Questionable call by the umpire. The way I saw it, that should have been an out, but I wasn't there. Greco taking a while deciding on this pitch. Out it comes. Way inside. Looks like it might have hit the batter. Yes, indeed it did. He'll make his way down to first base, and Salazzo will make his way to second. Now batting number 8, third baseman Sean Mattson.
third baseman, number 8, Sean Mattson.
No out, 2 men on, 1st and 2nd. Looked like he was going for a bunt, but he didn't bring the bat all the way around, and it was way outside, so that'll be ball 1. Greco trying to keep these guys off base. There's 2 men on there now, and it's the top of the 9th, and it's a tie game. Successful bunt, but it goes down, and it'll be foul. Now 1-1. Pitch goes outside, ball 2. Men still on 1st and 2nd. Greco's really not too concerned about stealing, although I think he should be, especially in a position like this with no out and men on. There's really nothing to lose by trying for the steal. Pitch outside, ball 3. The count is 3-1. Outside again, and Greco will walk the bases full. No outs, bases loaded, now batting designated hitter number 9, Justin Mara. I shouldn't say walk the bases loaded. One was a single, one was hit by pitch.
Two lucky winners with Royal Report lucky numbers 316 for a Montana's gift certificate and 269 for a Milestones gift certificate.
Score tied up at 5, top of the 9th, bases loaded, no men out. A meeting up at the mound. Play will resume. Batting, as I said, designated hitter number 9, Justin Mara, could change this game. Waiting on the pitch from Greco. Out it'll come. Inside and high, ball 1. Inside, ball 2. No out, bases loaded. Down near the bottom of the lineup for the Maple Leafs. 5-5 in the top of the 9th. Low and outside, ball 3. It's 3-0. This is a dangerous game that Ryan Greco is playing on the mound. Just on the inside edge of the box, that'll be called strike 1. Now 3-1. Hit hard, but bounced off the ground and gone foul. Now a full count. 0 out. Bases loaded. Pitch comes down. He'll walk in a run. It's now 6-5 for the Toronto Maple Leafs. Base is still loaded. Still no outs. Batting is the catcher, number 24, Brendan Keyes. But it looks like Greco's about to get another meeting on the mound. Second one this inning. Will he make it to the end of the inning? We'll see. Left fielder coming up. Jeff McLeod will now be pitching instead of Ryan Greco. Pitching substitution at the top of the ninth after walking in a bases loaded run with no outs. Ryan Greco pitched a very strong game before this inning. I'm surprised he buckled under the pressure the way he did, but I suppose a tie game in the top of the ninth is something challenging. Toronto Maple Leafs probably thanking their lucky stars for this one. If the Royals can't bring it at least one run in the bottom of this inning, that'll be that for them. And they better hope that Jeff McLeod can pitch a hitless inning. While we're here, might as well check in on the Major League Baseball scores. Not much of a change. Royals now leading Chi Sox 2-0. Jays still leading the Twins 2-0. That's middle of the sixth with the Royals and Chi Sox. Top of eight with the Jays and Twins. And still tied at zero, Phillies visiting the Braves in the top of the fourth. Playing ball now. Big swing and a miss from catcher number 24, Brendan Keyes, for strike one. Pitch number two, wild outside, ball one. Pitch hit over to second. Home plate for the force out there. Will it make it to first on time? Yes, indeed it will. The first plate umpire decides to make a call in our favor that time. That was a close one for sure. Double play to home and then first. Now two outs. No run scored on that one. Excellent fielding decision there as well. Now batting. Bottom of the lineup again, number three, Ryan White, the shortstop. Two out, two men on, second and third. A hit here just makes the game harder for the Royals at this point, but we're in a much better position now. A double play at home plate to first. 6-2-3. Inside, ball one. Jeff taking his time on the mound, makes a pitch, hit really hard but foul over the first baseline. Now 1-1. Dead air in the ballpark. Another one fouled back into the parking lot. 1-2, two out, two men on, second and third. Two in scoring position, one solid hit, and the Royals are in for trouble. Fouled back. Still 1-2. Hit hard out to third base. He dives and catches it. He makes the throw to the first base. It's on time. That'll be it for the inning. No more runs scored. It's just 6-5 as we head into the bottom of the ninth inning. Guelph Royals only with a deficit of one to make up to try to stay alive in this ballgame. After a really great 6-2-3 double play, amazing fielding choice by shortstop, number 23 Kingsley Alarcon, the ball was hit out to him. He could have thrown to third, could have thrown to second, could have thrown straight off to first and gotten at least one out. In fact, could have had a double play throwing to second or even third, but made the throw to home plate instead. Stopped the run there, and the throw was on time to first. Still on the mound, about to pitch a complete game, Dylan Mulholland, and opening for the bottom of the ninth will be Steven Satz, the designated hitter, 21. Mulholland has 151 pitches now this game, 92 of which were strikes. He warms up just throwing away. I'll be surprised if he can play again for a week after today. Just on his last warm-up pitch now. Mulholland throws it in, and up walks Steven Satz, the designated hitter. This is Guelph's last opportunity to close things off. They are trailing by one now in the bottom of the ninth.
Leading off for the Royals in the bottom of the ninth, the designated hitter, number 21, Steven Satz.
First pitch, ball one. Second one just outside for ball two. Umpire says that pitch, which looked almost the same as the last one, was just inside the box on the edge, now 2-1. Right on down the middle, called strike two. The count is even at two. Swing at that one, but it was inside, and that'll be a swinging strikeout for Steven Satz. Now batting catcher number 24, Saul Tweet. One out, nobody on in the bottom of the ninth. Guelph trailing by one. Top right top outside corner of the box, called strike one. Inside for ball one. On deck is number two, second baseman Trevor Knipe at the top of the lineup. Did the bat go around? First plate umpire says no. That'll be ball two on a pitch that went outside. Hits that one, bounces off the ground. Second baseman gets there in time, throws to first for out number two. Now back at the top of the lineup, number two, Trevor Knipe, the second baseman. With two out, nobody on. This could be it for the Guelph Royals this afternoon at David E. Hastings Stadium.
The batter, the second baseman, number two, Trevor Knipe.
First pitch outside for ball one. Low for ball two. Mulholland could be on his last batter to make this a complete game today. We'll get you the exact number of pitches and strikes at the end. That one in the box, called strike one. Way inside, ball three. Mulholland showing no signs of tiring. Knipe steps up for what could be the pitch that gets him on base. Swings and misses to make it a full count. 3-2, two out, nobody on. Guelph Royals trail by one in the last inning of their home game. The crowd is silent. Pitch comes in. It's inside. Trevor Knipe walks on to first. Two out, one man on. Here comes number 23, shortstop Kingsley Alarcon, the man who made the decision in the top of the ninth to make the 6-2-3 double play. Another chance for the Guelph Royals. Ball one. Mulholland taking his time now, not rushing any of the batters, watching that runner on first, throws it in, but it's low for ball one. Trevor Knipe advances to second because the catcher missed the ball. And he won't round that base, though. Two out, man on second, now in scoring position. This could really change the tide of the game. Meeting over at the mound, interesting time to pull your pitcher when he's about to finish his complete game, but I guess you got to do what you got to do to secure a win. Two and oh is the count, two out, with a man on second as the Royals trail by one in their home game. In the bottom of the ninth. 6-5 is the score. And play resumes. Mulholland remains on the mound. Watching that runner on second, he throws it over the plate. That's going to go through the box for a called strike one. Way high, wild pitch, ball three. the silence in this stadium. Everyone's holding their breath on every single pitch. Hits it down the third baseline. Will it be an out? Throws over to first. It's on time. That's out number three. The Guelph Royals could not bring it home. The Toronto Maple Leafs will take this game home 6-5 after an unfortunate top of the ninth for the Royals. I'll be right back in just a couple minutes. I'll have the final hits, errors, runs, and everything for you in just a minute. All right, I'm back. I've got the numbers for you in the 6-5 ball game. Dylan Mulholland, the pitcher for the Maple Leafs, played a complete game. He pitched 171 pitches in that game, 101 of which were strikes. Maple Leafs had those 6 runs in 9 hits with 1 error, while the Royals had their 5 runs in 6 hits with 2 errors. Thank you very much for tuning in. We'll be back in just a couple days on Monday with our home Victoria game. I'm Simon Gladstone. This was the Guelph Royals hosting the Toronto Maple Leafs on May 21st.